Hello, everyone, and welcome to theCUBE Studios in Palo Alto and the Google Cloud Partner AI Series. I'm your host, Rebecca Knight. We've got two terrific guests for this next segment. We've got John Maddison, Chief Product Officer and Corporate Marketing Officer at F5. Welcome.
Good to be here.
And Prerak Mehta, Director of Customer Engineering Strategic AI and ISV North America at Google Cloud. Welcome, Prerak.
Thank you for having me.
So I'm going to start with you, John. For the viewers who are unfamiliar with F5, why don't you tell them what you're all about and what you do.
Yeah, F5 is a company that's almost 30 years old. And like all companies, they started in a garage, because all companies start in a garage.
All good companies.
Yeah, all good companies. And a couple of students decided that, you know, the applications weren't scaling, and so they built a system to make that happen. It's called load balancing. Sometimes it's called application delivery controllers. They came up with a name, if you might badge there, F5, because F5, I think, is the highest tornado state. It's the most fierce tornado in protection-wise, and so that's why they came up with the name. We're headquartered in Seattle. Last year, around $3 billion, about 7,000 employees. We've expanded from our traditional kind of load balancing into WAP and cloud and NGINX for modern applications.
Excellent. Now, I want to put you in a bit of a reflective mood, because the partnership between F5 and Google dates back to 2018. How has that partnership evolved into the deep alliance that it is today?
Well, obviously, Google Cloud is a very important company out there, and many of our customers are joint, and they want to see us working together on new capabilities. I think, obviously, we're in the marketplace. We have about 50 different products that work there, but also some of our services, like our bot services, for example, work in Google Cloud. And then we're starting to work on what I call new cloud native services as we go forward. So it's marketplace, it's putting some of our services inside Google Cloud, and it's working on new capabilities as well. So it's a very, very strong partnership.
Prerak, similar question for you. From your perspective, what makes this F5 partnership so critical for Google Cloud customers, especially as they move into the AI and agentic AI era?
Great question. So Google just celebrated its 27th birthday.
Oh, we're older than
you. Yeah.
I'm older than Google. We all are, I guess. But it is fascinating to see, like, you know, the leaps and bounds of progress Google has made over the years in various technology fronts. One of the things that near and dear to me is how it's built. Google Cloud, initially, the infrastructure below it was built for this global search. And, you know, it was globally scalable the way it was, like, you know, cannot fail. It had multiple fail-safe processes, but when they decided to go in public cloud area, one of the things that they had to consider is how the enterprise customers run the application. Most of them tend to have a fallback policy, which in today's date and age is called multi-cloud, or like they, you know, diversify their risk not to be in one place. One of the things Google does really well is, you know, how we have built our security foundations. We made a lot of advancements. There's a lot of patents in the industry. We have a big slew of researchers that dedicatedly work on this. We have a team called Project Zero that's dedicated to it. But that is all within Google to secure Google traffic and protect Google from nation state actor threats and what have you. When I look at the partnership with F5 and similar partners, we think about our enterprise customers and what they want, right? And oftentimes, like, where they shine is in the area that is outside of the Google perimeter. We can secure very well within the perimeter. The value of this partnership really shines when we are looking at, you know, multi-cloud environment, when we're looking at on-prem and Google hybrid installations and what have you.
So, John, I want to ask you about that, too. In your conversations with leaders, what are some of the biggest security and performance challenges that they're facing right now, especially as it relates to the changing attack surface?
I think there's two topics that come up a lot. One, as you said, is hybrid multi-cloud, multi-cloud and hybrid. The second one, obviously, is Gen AI. So, you know, on the first one, because of regulation, because of data, because of multi-cloud, that's here to stay, I think. And I think companies or enterprises we speak to have that hybrid multi-cloud, and they're going to have it for a long time. So you have to be able to deploy in SaaS and hardware and software and native, which is why NGINX as a service is going to be really important to us. And the next one is AI. You know, we split it up into kind of four conversations. One is around delivery. Like, there's just a huge amount of data moving around. And so we use our load balancing technology in front of data stores or RAG or whatever to make sure that data moves around. There's what I call security for AI. And we did a recent acquisition of Calypso, which protects models, for example. There's AI for security. That's, you know, putting security, like AI assistance and technology inside your products. And so AI is not just one thing. It's three or four things which impact both our products, the way our customers deploy, and the way they want to make sure that their models and their AI infrastructure are protected.
Because the bad guys are using AI.
And the third one, the fourth one I didn't bring up is AI increases the attack surface. And so not only now have you got models, but eventually agentic and agents out there, so the attack surface itself is increased. And then the types of attacks, like prompt injections, for example, will be different. So yes, there's a lot of conversation around AI, but there's a lot of securing of AI that needs to happen.
Prerak, how do you see the multi-cloud operational complexity evolving, and why is it so hard for customers to solve it on their own?
So think about, I think you, John said the magic word, AI. You don't live in 2025, you don't think about AI. One of the key priorities for Google this year is investing. I think, in other words, we decided the folks who will potentially win the AI race are the ones who kind of sort of own the models, own the chips. So when you think about the very foundational level, we made significant strides in both of those areas. This is not new for us. We've been using models internally for like more than 10 years. You know, this is great within the Google Cloud landscape. But as we think about, as you mentioned, multi-cloud, one of the key things is securing traffic between, if you're thinking about a different cloud in Google Cloud, or an on-prem data center, Google Cloud, corporate offices. Securing is one thing. You'd also think about performance, right? Because, I mean, security and encryption can take a little bit of an overhead. I personally have been an FI user. I was a consultant prior to joining Google, and I used FI in all of my e-commerce customers. And the one thing that they kind of stand out for, and that's still true today, is they can provide very differentiated web and API security when thinking about multi-cloud deployments, especially in today's data and age. Think about a large bank. You know, banks have like significant amount of data. They give access, you know, to the analysts for like, you know, multiple data sources. And a lot of this data is confidential in nature, highly sensitive, a lot of PII information. As you mentioned, the biggest threat we have today securing AI models is from other AI. And I think when you are, you know, interacting with multiple entities on-prem, various clouds, I think you need a security layer that is looking from a layer above end-to-end, you know, between endpoints. And I think that is something they do really, really well, along with load balancing. So, I mean, three things I'll kind of sort of highlight is, you know, like FI, load balancing, firewalls, and, you know, the... Wow. Performance that they have on the security is unparalleled.
Yeah. Well, one interesting thing is the what I call the F5 data plane, which is a layer 7 data plane reverse proxy. Unlike, you know, a packet network can look at layer 7, and the layer 7 language for AI models are tokens. And so we see a future where there's a token engine, not a packet engine, that's making some decisions around routing or security going forward.
And that could really change things for customers, yes.
We partnered with F5 and NetApp to kind of create a solution to secure all the LLM traffic between different endpoints, including APIs, to provide our customers like, you know, secure and performance solution. So, I mean, I think the unique value, as I mentioned before, is, you know, when you have a vast amount of data and disparate data sources, it is very hard to secure from one particular place, and solutions like F5 kind of to stand out.
And that applies to so many different industries and enterprises that have data in disparate places.
I talked about financial services, but we see F5 in retail quite a bit as well, and media space too.
So, John, one of the things that Prerak said is such a strength of F5 is this load balancing across AI models, which sounds exceedingly technical, but it's quickly becoming a business critical issue for enterprises adopting generative AI. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, because you just mentioned the data. And so just think of the amount of data that's coming out of some of these storage systems. It's enormous. And so the ability to do AI data delivery, which is another form of load balancing, but just the name for it, is becoming critical. And make sure that not just in front of data stores, but in training models and inference models, for example, in RAG, the data is becoming critical, and moving it around at high speed with security is going to be very important.
Prerak, what is the role of Google's Gemini models, TPUs, and Vertex in this story, and how does F5's orchestration help them work together and become more powerful and also cost-effective for customers?
Great question. So if you think about Gemini models, Gemini is a large language model. We call them LLMs. Company's focus right now is to kind of sort of create diffusion models that is basically like, you know, focusing on audio, video, text-to-speech, what have you, that kind of stuff. And then, you know, then you have reasoning models that are more like doing mathematical computations with like hedge funds, like high-speed transactions, and or like scientific models, like molecular biology, like working on like drug compounds and stuff like that. So I think the near-term investment is to kind of sort of like refine Gemini model and focusing on upcoming models, getting better in that space on those three areas. The thing about TPU, I think one of the biggest constraints today in chips is power. So the advancement in the chip with the TPU v7 Ironwood coming out, I think the focus is to like shrink the footprint of power and physical footprint of the chip itself while creating a 48x performance to the prior version. So I think we are making significant strides in that chip space and in the LLM space. But as you think about, you know, our partnership with F5 and from my end customer standpoint, they will use multiple models at any given point of time to do different things. While we have great models, we also have the notion of Vertex AI, which is an AI platform. Yep. We have multiple models in it. We have a model garden. We partner really well with our competition, like Anthropic. We have some open source models. And customers use all kinds of models to do all kinds of things. They might use Gemini, get an output, and send the summarization to a different open source model that's running on a GKE cluster. That might be running somewhere else. To secure that traffic, we rely on the likes of F5 to provide performant, bi-directional, high-speed data transfer between models, and also like secure end-to-end customer data.
Yeah, and I think, you know, Google Cloud has realized, as with hybrid multi-cloud, that you need different models in there.
Maybe.
So you're opening up to different partners. And for us, we did a recent acquisition of a company called Calypso AI. It's actually based in Ireland, in Dublin. And they'd really focused on protecting models, not just a specific model, but up to 12 different models out there. And in fact, they run about 10,000 attacks each month against the different models and give them a ranking and then put it into the product. So we see, you know, long term, that's already working inside Google Cloud. So for those, some of those other models that the companies are using, then maybe that's a product offering we can provide.
So John, NGINX as a service is about to launch for Google Cloud. What makes this offering different, and why should customers be paying attention?
Because I think you can put all your products in the marketplace and load them up, and that's fine. But what's so powerful about Google Cloud and its applications is it's cloud native. Mm-hmm. It works natively with everything inside there. However, sometimes they need a different application or different features, and different functions. So NGINX as a service is a very well-known load balancing application as well as web server. And so, yes, it's available on NGINX on the marketplace, but now we've integrated it as a cloud-native SaaS application right inside Google. We worked alongside their engineers so that the customer can now decide, yes, they can still use the Google load balancing, but if they want something that works maybe across multiple clouds or some of the features of NGINX, which they're used to on-premise or whatever, they can now spin it up as a cloud-native just as easily as, you know, as the native load balancing itself.
And it, does it help them deliver value more quickly, would you say? Or
yeah, I think it's just different applications. I think for customers, they have a choice. There's the native tools they have, and they're great. But sometimes they want certain features that another application has, but they don't like the ability, the mess of spinning up hardware and managing themselves and patching themselves. They want it to be cloud native. They want it to be SaaS. And that will be the power of the new offering we've got together.
Okay, so as we wrap up here, whether it's NGINX as a service, which is soon to launch, or Calypso AI, what do you both see as the most exciting opportunities for this partnership to expand in the next 12 to 18 months? How about you, why don't you start, Prerak?
I think, you know, John mentioned it. I'm excited about their latest acquisitions and, you know, the latest suite of SaaS offerings. I know we are also like working on some of this in this space, and like Model Armor is one of those things that's coming out. But I think it's an exciting space. And I think, you know, there's a lot of work still needs to be done to like secure AI. For me, that's the biggest area of partnership with F5 is as we kind of explore like and come up with new models, as agent space and agents kind of mature and start doing more than basic things, I think we'll need these tools to be very smart and very sophisticated to prevent, you know, bad actors from penetrating into our systems. So I think FI and Google will play a critical role there in creating joint solutions.
And fighting our adversaries. Yes, John, how about you?
Yeah, I mean, that's a great one. There's others as well. But I just like the attitude of the Google Cloud teams. It's like, hey, yes, I can do everything myself if I want, but they're offering a customer choice. And so we like working with them because they're open about that. Yes, they have their own products that sometimes we compete with, but they're open in saying that if the customer wants this, then I need to make sure it's inside my cloud. And that's why we like working with Google Cloud.
Good attitude. All right, I like it. John and Prerak, thank you both so much for coming on the show. Really fascinating conversation.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you for tuning in to this edition of the Google Cloud Partner AI series. We hope you'll stay tuned for more.